Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about the access control allow origin header. So let's get started. When the access control allow origin response header is implemented, it will be included in the response of one server to another that is making the cross origin request. In addition, it will specify which request origin is allowed. The client then compares the website's origin requesting access to the one specified in the header response by the domain serving the resource to determine if they match. If they do, it proceeds with the request and allows code running on the requesting website to access the response. If the origin is not included in the header, the browser will not share the server response. Typically, access control allow origin responses are passed to the requesting origin without credentials such as cookies or authorization headers, even if these are sent with the request. However, using the access control allow credentials true along with access control allow origin will allow the actual request to be made and the response to be read. Access control allow origin can have several values. These are the wildcard value, the null value, and the specific origin values you wish to allow. Allowed origins must be included in a list against which the server will check origin requests. The request will be granted if the domain is included in the list. The wildcard value means that requests from any domain are allowed. This value is typically used and considered safe when the content on a domain is considered public and intended to be freely accessible. In other words, it is the appropriate value for requests without credentials. This value does not allow for requests to supply credentials, i.e. HTTP authentication, cookies, and client-side certificates, and cannot be used with another value. Allowing for access control allow credentials true, along with a wildcard via a workaround, can be very dangerous as it can expose authentication information to untrusted parties. Servers should not use the null value for an origin, as it may create a vulnerability. Setting the origin to null leaves the door open for attackers to generate requests containing a null value in the origin header. If the null value is whitelisted, an attacker's inclusion in the header will be allowed. On the attacker's side, null may be associated with a malicious file that will provide it with access to the server's resources. Does access control allow origins support multiple origins? While the header does support multiple origins, browsers usually do not. A whitelist of permitted domains must be created to offer support to multiple origins. However, this must be done carefully, as blanket access permission to a domain and all of its subdomains may easily open the door to unwanted visitors and requests. How to enable access control allow origin headers? To enable the use of these headers, you must first add CORS support to your server. See the Enable CORS website for a full breakdown to learn how to implement CORS for a specific platform. We will provide you with all the information required to implement CORS and access control allow origin headers for the stated software. These days, enforcing security policies on web applications is relatively easy using the correct headers in HTTP responses. Take the following example of an application. https://example.org delivers the front end of the great example applications to its users. This is the domain a user knows. https://api.example.org is handling all information. If the user logs in, the front end sends a request to this domain and changes according to the response. In this case, it should not be possible for anybody else but the front end to access the API. By now, browsers try to protect the user and block malicious requests. For example, such a request would be to visit https://malicious.example.org, and the web application there would try to access https://api.example.org. To prevent that, the web server delivering the API can send the access control allow origin header as follows. Access control allow origin, https://example.org. The malicious website has no more access to our API if the user uses a recent browser. The malicious website has no more access to our API if the user uses a recent browser. No security headers set. Better use them when developing a web application. If the application setup becomes more complex, things get much more complicated to configure. Assume that there are more systems. https://staging.example.org, which holds the staging environment of the front end. https://payment.example.org, the external payment provider that needs to access the API to confirm payments. https://localhost8080, is the local server that the developer uses to try out changes locally. The access control allow origin header cannot contain multiple domains, like separating different domains via spaces or commas. Besides specifying a single domain, only star is another valid option, which would allow access from everywhere. And this is no secure option in this case. Therefore, the OPI needs to check the request's origin and adjust the header field accordingly. For example, it can use the origin header on the request to check who is accessing the resource. If one of the allowed domains, it sets the access control allow origin accordingly. Otherwise, it just sets it to https://example.org so that the browser blocks the request. The following example explains how a Laravel project can make use of middleware to set this header correctly. In this case, it should not be possible for anybody else but the front-end to access the API. By now, browsers try to protect the user and block malicious requests. For example, such a request would be to visit https://malicious.example.org, and the web application there would try to access https://api.example.org. To prevent that, the web server delivering the API can send the access control allow origin header as follows. In addition to the access control allow origin header, the vary header is set so that the browser knows that this API's response may vary depending on the origin. Therefore, it will not use any cached response when the API is called from a different front-end site in the same browser. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.